presidential race frontrunner Ferdinand Marcos Jr. says there is a need to boost the partnership of the Philippines with the United States in terms of trade and not just assistance. Marcos made that statement after a meeting with U.S. Chargé d'Affaires Heather Varyava, who paid him a courtesy visit Monday. His pitch comes as Marcos seeks to lure more investors to public-private partnership deals under his administration.
We would welcome any assistance for the economy that we can get from the United States. But I think that not only a dependence on aid from the United States, but also in trade not aid. Balik pa rin tayo doon, trade not aid. And so to open the government, the bureaucracy, this administration, to the possibilities of private partnerships, joint venture from the Philippines and with the American. Marami naman tayong history sa ganyan. Marami nagbubukas dito ng kumpanya na American for a long time now. So that is a well-established route or role that we have.
In 2020, the Philippines was the 30th largest goods export market of the U.S., according to data from the Office of the U.S. Trade Representative. Meanwhile, U.S. foreign direct investments in the Philippines was at $5.2 billion during the same period. Now, aside from the U.S. Chargé d'Affaires, three other diplomats paid courtesy visit to Marcos at his headquarters in Mandaluyong City Monday. There were Japanese Ambassador Koshikawa Kazuhiko, South Korean Ambassador Kim In-chul, and Indian Ambassador Shambhu Kumaran. And among topics discussed were security concerns and the possible revival of the Bataan nuclear power plant, which was built during the time of his father, the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr.
Siyempre, security concerns, pinag-usapan namin the return or the re-signing or the extension of the VFA agreement and how it has to be redefined for the near future with the changing situation around the world, especially in our region.
Marcos described the envoy's visit as a recognition of the new administration.
Maybe the comfortable margin that we enjoyed during the election has a part to play with that. Ang aking lang laging pinapaalala sa kanila, sinasabi ko, palagay ko, sa pandemyang ito, ang recovery ng lahat natin ay hindi kakayanin ng kahit isang bansa, kahit gano'ng kayaman. Kailangan the partnerships will be the one that will bring us through. Keep the global economy at least as stable as is possible.
President Rodrigo Duterte agrees the next administration should explore the possibility of using nuclear energy in the Philippines, especially amid rising oil prices. Oil prices have surged more than 10 straight weeks as the Russia-Ukraine war affected the global crude oil supply since late February this year. But Duterte also echoed the warnings of experts. There are risks of using a nuclear power plant, such as radiation leaks.
Total ang nag-umpisa naman nito kasi Marcos noon nagpagawa siya ng nuclear plant. Nuclear is forever. Kaya lang medyo ma-delikado to. Kagaya ng sa Chernobyl ng Ukraine, nagkaroon ng leak.
Two government veterans are joining the cabinet of leading presidential bet Bongbong Marcos. Arsenio Balisacan, who chairs the Philippine Competition Commission, confirms he has accepted Marcos's offer for him to again lead the National Economic Development Authority. Balisacan previously headed the agency during the administration of then-President Benigno Aquino III. The Estrada administration's former labor secretary, Bienvenido Laguesma, has also accepted his nomination to assume his previous post.
all the issues that are still burning issues today.
Yeah.
Yun din ang mga nakita ko noon, hindi lang siguro masyadong nabibigyan ng masyadong atensyon at hindi nagkakaroon talaga ng real partnership with the labor and the employer sector. Balance is a difficult thing to achieve, but with their trust, support, cooperation, I think any heavy burden will be lighter than expected.
Meanwhile, Susan Toots Ople has agreed to head the Migrant Workers Department. The Philippine Congress is all set to canvass the votes in the May 9th presidential and vice presidential races. Lawmakers hope to proclaim the country's next leaders this week. RG Cruz with this report.
It was dawn of Monday when about 167 ballot boxes containing certificates of canvass and 441 election returns were transported under heavy military and police guard from the Senate to the House of Representatives. Only 156 of the 173 expected certificates of canvass have been sent by the Senate to the House. At the House, these were stored under heavy guard at the newly renovated session hall. By 10 a.m. of Tuesday, the Senate and the House will convene a joint public session as the National Board of Canvassers for President and Vice President. One of their first acts, adopt the canvassing rules, then elect the 7 lawmakers from each chamber and 4 alternates from each chamber who will sit in the Joint Canvassing Committee, which will go through each of the 173 certificates from the provinces, cities, overseas voting posts, and local absentee voting. The certificates will be opened by the joint session before referring these to the committee. At the committee level, its members, along with the watchers and lawyers of the candidates, will check if the votes in the electronically transmitted certificates will match those in the physically transmitted certificates. If they match, the physically transmitted COC will be checked for due execution, the signatures and the thumb marks of the canvassing board, if it reflects the names of the candidates and their votes in figures, and if there are discrepancies. If there are no discrepancies, the result is admitted into the official tally. If there are discrepancies, the certificate may be deferred pending an explanation from the canvassing board and a ruling of the committee. Senators and congressmen vote separately to resolve conflicts. If there is a tie, the speaker and the Senate president will decide.
Pag na-convene na yun, magsa-start na tayo ng canvas, no? So iaano natin, i-open yung lahat ng COCs, i-compare siya, at saka titingnan yung if any may mga alterations siya. Normally doon kasi discrepancies na ano na makikita doon sa pag wala naman, so tuloy-tuloy lang. So, dapat magka-match yung ano yung sa electronically transmitted versus doon sa ano sa physically counted na mga ballots.
The COC.
COCs, yes.
Once the committee is done with all the certificates, it will submit a committee report and resolution of both houses to the joint public session, which will then be the basis to proclaim the president-elect and the vice-president-elect. By its own timetable, the joint committee will start at 2 in the afternoon of Tuesday, and it won't stop till the canvass is over, which is why it is possible the winners can be proclaimed this week. Speaker Lord Alan Velasco had already guaranteed to canvass the votes expeditiously and with transparency. The canvass is not expected to take long as the elections are automated. In 2016, Congress only took 3 days to canvass before proclaiming winners. In 2004, Congress proclaimed the winners with just 6 days to go before the turnover of power in what was the last manual election in Philippine history. On Monday, both the House and the Senate adopted their resolutions, convening the joint public session by Tuesday. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.